Tampa City leaders are creating some new safety protocols for fans attending the upcoming Super Bowl in Tampa in February.
But as ABC Action News reporter Lauren Rosella found out, this could have a big impact on how local businesses can advertise to really capitalize on the big game.
The city of Tampa is looking to create clean zones. That means that any vendor or business who wants to operate within one will need to get permission from both the NFL and the city of Tampa in order to promote anything connected to the event. They'll also pay a fee. Here are the two proposed clean zones side by side. One around Raymond James Stadium and the second is a large chunk of downtown Tampa. Clean zones will affect what thousands of NFL fans will see in and around the big game. This includes what's posted on signs and tents. It regulates outdoor activities too and what's sold. For fans, it can be a protection against counterfeit items and scams. Clean zones prevent vendors from selling non-licensed NFL gear. But this also means that local restaurants and stores located inside these clean zones will need to apply for special use permits to capitalize on Super Bowl hype. The fee is $75. The zones will be in effect from January 28th until midnight on February 9th. Local authorities will be enforcing these clean zones, and violators could be fined as much as $450. In Tampa, I'm Lauren Rosella, ABC Action News.